Hey guys, welcome back to a new video, and in this video we are going to see how to create a container transformation animation in Jetpack Compose. So this is our end product, and here you can see we have a floating action button, and when you click on this floating action button you will see a transition, or you can say container transformation. We are going to see how to build this in Jetpack Compose, so let's get started. So you can get all of this initial code from my GitHub repository, link is present in the description box. Now if you notice the animation, you will notice that we have two different state, floating action button state and second one is the full screen state. So in order to represent these two states, I'm going to create a seal interface container state, and within this I'm going to create an object naming fab, and second object is full screen. Okay, now within our composable function I'm going to create state. So I'm calling this state, remember, mutable state of basically container state. Okay, and the initial value of this thing is floating action button, because initially I want to show floating action button, that is why. Now depending on this state, I'm going to create a variable naming transition. So this transition is actually initialized with the help of update transition, and its target state would be state from value. And one more thing, I want padding, or you can say animated padding. So this padding is actually initialized with the help of transition animate DP. Now let me import this thing first. Okay, so here within our animate DP you will notice we receive container state, so we need to check its state. So if it is a type of floating action button, on that scenario I want 12 DP padding, or if it is a case of full screen I want 0 DP padding. Okay, if you want to add label you can add it too. Okay, it's not very necessary. And one more thing, transition specification, so basically the type of animation which you want to show. So I want twin, and duration would be 500 milliseconds. Okay, so these three variables is actually used in order to achieve our desired transition. Now jump into your scaffold main content. This main content contain a box, and within this box we have a lazy column. Just below to this lazy column I'm going to create one more box having a modifier fill max size, and the content alignment would be on the bottom end. Okay, and within this box I'm going to use my transition, and with the help of this transition we are going to call animated content, and this animated content will give us container state. So check your container state. So basically we have two different things, floating action button. So if it is a case of floating action button, I'm going to create a floating action button. Okay, on the click of this floating action button I want to change my state value would be container state full screen, and the composable for this floating action button would be an image. So image, that is using image vector. So here I'm going to pass my icon default add circle, and the content description would be as always null. If you want to pass anything else you can do it by yourself. Okay, so this is a case of floating action button. Now what will happen if I have the container state full screen, and within this full screen container state I'm going to create a box having modifier fill max size, and I also want to draw behind a rectangle. So draw a rectangle having color white, so in order to cover the background. Otherwise if you don't use this draw behind thing, your container would be actually representing in a transparent way. So your content is visible, but you can also able to see the content which is present behind of this screen. So that is why I am using draw behind in order to draw the background color. Okay, now within this box I am going to create a text that says this is transformed screen. That's it. And one more thing, I want to change my box background color. The color would be color gray. Yeah, And yep, everything is fine. And one more thing, I want my content alignment would be center. Okay, so we are done with this full screen thing. And one more thing, I actually forgot the padding that we had created over here. So this padding is actually used in the box over here. So in within this box, I'm going to use padding, padding value dot dp. That's it. Now go to your main activity, and here I already passed this container transformation composable. Now I am going to execute it. So when you click on this floating action button, you will see the transition, and after the transition you will notice the screen. Now when I click on this screen, nothing happened. So I want the vice versa behavior. So in order to do that, go to your container transformation, and here in the box I am going to introduce clickable, and when user click onto this, I'm going to change my container state value from full screen to floating action button. Now it's time to execute it. Okay, so when you click on this floating action button, you will notice the transformation. And when you click on this box again, you will notice the reverse transition. Okay, so yeah, you using this approach, you can actually perform a container transformation. I hope you like this video. We'll meet in our next video where we can discuss some more stuff regarding the Jetpack Compose animation or anything else. So yeah, that's it for this video. Bye.